Hello techies, I welcome you all to this wonderful journey where we learn and study with Food Technopatty. So in our first part, we had discussed regarding basics of hyperspectral imaging system. So in this second part, we will take a look at what are the advantages of imaging system and spectrophotometric method one by one. But before we actually get started, if you're new here and you haven't already, then make sure you do a tap on the little red subscribe button and turn on the notification bells and be a part of this buddy family. USFDA conducted research regarding how this image sensing technology can be used for various food commodities such as fruits, vegetables, poultry, meat products, milk products, etc. Now, just as a pro tip, let me tell you that this technology plays a very important role when batch process does not take place, which means in case of inline processing, or you can say continuous inline process. So the reason behind this is, since the process is continuous, so the chances of defects increases and it becomes very tedious task for the food industry people when it comes to identifying such defects. So for a better understanding, let's take a look at this picture. Here, being a food technologist, first and foremost important thing that you will check while filling a bottle is its headspace. But hold on a second, what if I ask you to identify any defect present in this? Well, you would probably say, this doesn't sound easy. Well, I agree with you, it's not that easy. In such cases, we use this image sensing technology, which basically means if the headspace, or you can say filling space of bottle, is less than off-filled ones, then it will be automatically separated from the filled bottles. Although these bottles are later recycled. Now when I'm saying recycled, then here I'm talking about so whatever we have discussed till now, by doing all this, our main aim is to minimize two things. Number one is quality defects, and number two is safety issues, as they play a very important role when it comes to consumer health. Coming on to application of hyperspectral imaging system in food industry, let's take a look at how it is advantageous for poultry industry. So here, we basically use this to study or measure carcass length, its defects, and various color changes can be measured by spectrophotometric method. Once it senses any defect, it will be separated from the Coming on to measuring freshness in case of aqua products, then this technology is not less than a miracle. So basically, now we can say we can use this technology to check freshness. Now, you must be thinking how we can visually differentiate once we get the data. So to answer this, if fish is spoiled, so image will look something like this. Else, if the fish is fresh, so it will look something like this. So I hope you got a clear picture now of how it actually works. Now, along with freshness, we can also get an idea regarding its storage condition. One amazing thing about this technology is you can also get a clear picture about which part is damaged, which basically means at cellular level. Now, apart from this, it also helps in predicting storage life of the product. You all must have read somewhere, or most of you might have seen, that if you store fish in a packet and suppose it gets spoiled after some time, then the packet changes color. It is very obvious that if you see a color change in the packet, it clearly indicates that fish has spoiled. This is also an example of sensing technology. How? I'll tell you. Have you ever noticed the color of packet in which aqua products are marketed? Yes, you guessed it right. It is always in blue colored packets. Now, what is the color change that we notice in this case? So here, if fish is spoiled, the blue color changes to yellow color, which basically indicates that the product is now unfit from consumption point of view. So with this, I hope now it is quite easy for you all to relate that how such kind of modern technology is being used in food industry to monitor quality control aspects of fish products. Moving on, this technology is also used for detecting damaged apples. Now, this damage can be caused because of different reasons, such as harvesting, any equipment which is used for handling, or due to compression, abrasion, etc. Now, the reason why food industry has to identify such damage and separate it from the rest is that sometimes if we don't identify this at an early stage, then over a period of time, it may become habitat for microbial growth, and which makes it unfit for human consumption. Now, this basically means that product quality suffers a lot if not detected early. Now, coming on to another application is for detecting any fungal growth in case of citrus fruits. Actually, what happens in this case is, if even a small number of fruit becomes infected, then it can spread to the whole lot. So it becomes a very necessary step, especially when they are exported, or you can say long-term transportation wherever it is involved. Now the question that arises here is, why are we so concerned about this fungal growth? So the answer is, if we do not detect this at an early stage, then aflatoxins and mycotoxins can enter our body and cause various health issues. So this was all about the advantages of image sensing technology in food industry. Now what if we combine this with spectrophotometric? So when we combine this image sensing and spectrophotometric method, then we can measure various compositions as well. So let's suppose you have a watermelon, or say muskmelon, or any other fruit. So with the help of this technology, we can measure what is the sugar distribution in a particular fruit. Also, how this concentration varies with ripening, and we can get an idea, suppose if sugar distribution is not uniform, so we can get an idea that how long it will take to distribute this uniformly throughout the fruit. And you all know that we measure this in terms of degree bricks. So now you all must have got an idea that how this technology differs from the normal conventional method of measuring sugar concentration. How we can miss very important unit operations such as sorting and grading. This technology basically is very useful when it comes to sorting and grading of ripened, semi-ripened and completely ripened fruits. With the help of this technology, we can separate this very easily. Now, coming on to pickling process, all the defects can easily be identified with the help of this hyperspectral imaging system. Okay, now let's take a look at this picture. What if I ask you to detect internal quality of this wheat kernel? So now, since you know about this modern technology, so you will probably say, yes, we can do this with the help of hyperspectral imaging system. So here, in this case, what we do is we try to measure its protein content, and we all know that wheat quality depends totally on how much protein is present inside wheat kernel. Since now we know its application, advantages in various food industries, let me also tell you that few companies like Pepsi, Coca-Cola, they are using this hyperspectral imaging technology. Now you can easily relate this with the example that we have taken in the starting of this video, that is in case of bottle and headspace. So that's it for today, techies. I hope you all have enjoyed this session. See you in the next video. Till then, stay safe, take care, bye.